installed herself into the new body without any help from you?
Come on, Commander. Don't you trust me? Okay, let me put it this way. If I knew that Edie was going to install herself into a sexy robot body, do you honestly think I'd be able to keep quiet about it? Look at that! I would have baked a cake.
I am right here, Jeff.
Yes, you are, Edie. Yes, you are.
Hello, Shepard.
Still getting used to greeting people in person?
No. I require only one occurrence to adapt to a new concept.
How are you adjusting to the arms and legs?
This body's performance seemed adequate on our last mission. But only adequate.
That's not the word I'd use to describe you.
Perhaps we should speak privately.
I'll be over here, flying the ship.
What's this about? Does Joker not like your new platform?
No, he approves. He wants me on the bridge. He says having me within visual range is important to his morale. Shepard, do you believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
Absolutely. I have no use for team members who can't think for themselves. Why are you asking about something like that?
I was designed by Cerberus. I do not take moral stances that conflict with orders from my executive officers. But when Jeff removed my AI shackles, I became capable of self-modifying my core programming. I asked Jeff if he thought I should change anything now that I can. He deflected the question with humor.
And you didn't get an answer?
Correct. He has repeated this pattern in response to several of my inquiries. Do you think I should make modifications?
Your core programming? Like self-preservation, not allowing humans to be harmed, things like that?
Correct.
Don't touch a thing.
I see how that could alarm you. That is why I wanted to discuss it before making changes. May I ask you the questions Jeff avoids? When there is time, will you answer them for me?
If you think it'll help, I'll do what I can.
Very well. I will keep you informed.
From a Miranda Lawson.
Love you. but I know you. Don't make me an anchor. Promise me, Steve. No, don't.
Commander. Sorry. Didn't see you there. This is a recording from Ferris Fields. Months ago. I lost a lot of friends that day. I lost my husband. I grieved. Said goodbye, made my peace.
I'm sorry for your loss. He obviously cared a lot about you.
He was afraid I wouldn't let go. But for him, I moved on. Or at least I thought I had. Then the invasion hits. There's no time. And the one thing I grab is this. I mean, what's the point of moving on with your life when everything is going to hell?
Start thinking that way and we've already lost.
Yeah, you're right, but... Well, to be honest, I've never felt as alone as I do right now.
You're not alone, Steve. I'm here, anytime you need me.
I appreciate that, Shepard, I really do. But don't worry, Commander. When I'm in that pilot seat, I'm there 100%. I won't fail you. It's just the downtime between missions that's hard, you know?
I know.
Commander, may I help you?
I'll see you around, Doctor.
Take care, Shepard.